हेलो एंड वेलकम टू आसान है एजुकेशन। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस एन इम्पॉर्टेंट इंडेक्स विच इज़ रिलीज्ड बाय UNFPA यूनाइटेड नेशंस पॉपुलेशन फंड। दिस रिपोर्ट इज टाइटल्ड आर नेम्ड एज स्टेट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ इन द वर्ल्ड। ओके, सो लेट अस सी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट एंड वी विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट UNFPA। वॉट इज UNFPA, वॉट इज द वर्क ऑफ UNFPA। सो यू विल बी एबल टू इनकॉर्पोरेट ऑल दिस डिटेल्स इन योर मेन्स आंसर राइटिंग वाइल यू आर राइटिंग answer related to population and associated issues. Also you can incorporate these details in your essay writing when you are writing topic related to population and associated issues or demographic dividend, which is talked about that India is a country which is going through a demographic dividend phase, and if we have to take the maximum output from this demographic dividend, then we have to invest in our health, education and basic facilities. Okay, so that we can take the maximum output of our demographic dividend. So let us discuss this report in great detail and we will also see what is UNFPA and what is the work of UNFPA. See what this report says. This is the report of UNFPA, State of the World Population Report 2018, and this report was released in 2019. So according to UNFPA, India's large youth bulge will continue to fuel population growth, says the report. You can see the population of world is 7.7 billion. In 2019, China's population is 1.4 billion and we are very close to China, and we stand at 1.37 billion. And United States population is 329 million. Indonesia is the fourth largest country in terms of population with 269 million and Brazil stand at fifth position. So the question can come that arrange in the ascending order, the top five countries are China, India, United States, Indonesia and Brazil. You can see the annual rise percentage between 2010 and 2019. China's annual rise between 2010 to 2019 was 0.5% and world's average was 1.1%. But see, India's average is also greater than world's average. It is 1.2%. And we are increasing at a double rate than China. Okay. United States' average annual rise was 0.7%. Indonesia's 1.2%, Brazil 0.8%. Now let us see the fact related to life expectancy in year 2019. See, world's life expectancy is 72 years. Life expectancy means the average years which we will live, or the for how long we will be alive. So the average life expectancy year is 72 years. In China it is 77 years and we have increased to 69 years. In United States it is highest, 80 years. In Indonesia, it is 70 years and in Brazil, it is 76 years. So the fact which you must remember is that India will take over China by 2027. This report also says that, UNFPA report also says that India will overtake China in terms of population by 2027 and India will become the most populated country in the world. Okay, so by 2027, we will be overtaking China as well. And one more fact you have to remember, see population by age. And this is known as the demographic dividend because our largest population is in the age group of 0 to 14 and 15 to 64, which is known as the working age population as well. See, population by age percentage. In world, 65 plus. See, if we see the population in world, 0 to 14, it is only 9%. 0 to 14 means the population between 0 to 14. When we see at world level, it is only 9%. And 15 to 64, it is 65%. And okay, see, and when we population by percentage means, suppose if there is 100% population and what is the division, what is the distribution of population in different age group, for example 0 to 14 and 15 to 64, and 15 to 64 is known as working age population. And when we see India, you can check, only 6% of the population is in the age bracket of 65 and 65 plus. And our major population is in the age group of 0 to 14, which comprises of 27%. And 67% of our population is in the age bracket of 15 to 64. This is the reason that we are said that India is passing through a phase of demographic dividend. And if we want to take the maximum output of our demographic dividend, then we will have to sufficiently spend. And we will also have to increase our expenditure on the health and education sector and research and development sector as well. Okay, and if we compare ourselves with China, China's population in the age group of 15 to 64 is 71%, but China's population in the age bracket of 65 and above, it is 12%, and in the age bracket of 0 to 14, it is 18%. Okay, So you have to remember the population related to India specific. Once again I will tell this so that you can remember better. In world, the population in the age group of 65 and above is 9%. In the age bracket of 0 to 14, it is 26%, and 15 to 64, it is 65%. And when we talk about India specific, India's population composition in the age group of 65 and plus, it is 6%. In 0 to 14 age group, if we'll talk about, this is 27%, and 0 to 14 is the dependent population because they cannot earn by themselves. But see the population of India in the age bracket of 15 to 64, which is known as working age population according to UN and WHO. And we are having a 67% population in the age bracket of 15 to 64. And this is the reason that India is known to be passing through a phase of demographic dividend. Okay. See one more important fact. 2.7% of the population was registered annual. 2.7% population growth was registered in the least developed countries, mostly in Africa, have the fastest growing population. So the countries which are illiterate, which are least developed, have registered the highest population growth, especially in Africa. We have registered a population growth rate of 2.7% annually. Okay, one more fact you can see. Least developed countries are 47 nations with the lowest socio-economic indicators, poverty, human resource, economic vulnerability, according to UN Human Development Index rating. Okay. So this report also says that the countries which are least developed, which are not so educated and so developed, they have registered the highest population growth rate, and Africa has registered a population growth rate of 2.7%. Okay. So now let us see what is UNFPA, United Nations Population Fund. See, this can be very important for your prelims point of view. The question can come about United Nations Population Fund. So you have to remember this fact as well. Okay. See, United Nations Population Fund. United Nations Population Fund is the United Nations Sexual and Reproductive Health Agency. It was established as a trust fund in 1967 and began operations in 1969. So United Nations Population Fund is the United Nations Sexual and Reproductive Health Agency. It was established as a trust fund in 1967 and began operations in 1969. Let us see some more fact. In 1987, UNFPA was officially renamed the United Nations Population Fund. However, the original abbreviation UNFPA, United Nations Fund for Population Activities, was retained. So, originally the full name of UNFPA was United Nations Fund for Population Activities, but in 1987 it was renamed as United Nations Population Fund. And what is the work of United Nations Population Fund? You can see the mandate of United Nations Population Fund is established by United Nations Economic and Social Council, which is also a main organ of United Nations. This United Nations Population Fund is a subsidiary of organ of United Nations General Assembly. Okay, you have to remember all these facts. That the mandate of UNFPA is established by United Nations Economic and Social Council, and UNFPA is a subsidiary organ of United Nations General Assembly. Okay, this UNFPA is entirely supported by voluntary contribution of donor government, intergovernmental organization, the private sector and foundations and individuals, and not by United Nations regular budget. You have to remember this fact. This fact is very important, that UNFPA is entirely supported by voluntary contribution of donor government, intergovernmental organizations, the private sector and foundations, and the regular budget of United Nations does not fund the United Nations Population Fund. Okay, you have to remember this fact. See, this is UNFPA is not funded by the United Nations regular budget. And how the UNFPA works? See, UNFPA works directly to tackle sustainable development goal number 3 on health, goal number 4 on education, and goal number 5 on gender equality. So you have to remember this fact as well, that UNFPA works directly to tackle SDG. What are the SDGs? The goals which we have to achieve by 2030. And this works goal number 3, goal number 4, and goal number 5. Okay, thank you for watching. Have a great day.